It is something you may be too embarrassed to talk about, but it affects an awful lot of people. Not being able to control your urine.
Tonight, medical reporter Susan Shapiro looks into bladder incontinence.
I said, please just take me home.
At 67, Helen Gilbert says she still has a love for life. But the Denver Lancaster County woman has no love for her incontinence.
It's a pain in the butt. It really is, because you want to go out and you want to enjoy yourself, and if you don't make it to the bathroom in time, even your depends gets wet.
The National Association for Continence estimates that one in four women over the age of 50 and one in 10 men has urinary incontinence. But even younger women can be affected, especially after childbirth.
There are two main causes of urinary incontinence. One is an overactive bladder, where you feel like you have to run to the restroom all the time. The other is weak pelvic muscles.
When we talk about pelvic muscles, we're talking about that whole set.
Nurse practitioner Doris Yoder, who runs the Bladder Center in Lancaster, says those weak muscles cause what is known as stress incontinence.
The muscles drop, and so everything in the bladder and everything else in the abdominal cavity drops a little too, and that dropping then puts pressure on the bladder and causes the bladder leaking. When we cough or sneeze or lift, we're increasing the pressure in our abdomen, and that pressure then is pushing down against our pelvic muscles.
Hard and hold it. 2, 3, 4.
Yoder uses biofeedback to help diagnose urinary incontinence.
Again, pull in again.
Her sister, Lisa Buckwalter, volunteered to be the subject here.
To get down.
Sensors placed in her pelvic area allowed Yoder to view on her computer the strength of Buckwalter's pelvic muscles.
Again, pull in.
What Yoder refers to as the invisible muscles.
I was surprised that it didn't feel as invasive as I thought it would be.
Yoder says a majority of people who have stress incontinence or overactive bladder, known as urge incontinence, can be helped.
The sooner you can address and get some help with the problem, the better it is, because you can help prevent it from getting worse.
Now, here are a few questions to ask yourself. Do you urinate more than 6 to 8 times a day? Do you hate to laugh, sneeze, or cough because you may leak urine? Do you leak urine on the way to the bathroom? If you answered yes to any of these questions, you could have a problem. And we have more questions in the Bladder Health Quiz on our website, WGAL.com. And tomorrow, guys, we'll be talking about some of the things you can do to control and hopefully alleviate these urinary incontinence problems, which, as you have said, are a problem for a lot of people. That's coming up tomorrow at 6.
1 out of 4 people over a
over the age,
age
of 50. Yeah. We need to clarify.
Still,
that.
That's a lot.
But Doris Yoder also says people think it comes naturally with aging. She says it doesn't have to be that way.
All right. Interesting. Thank you.
Susan.
Look forward to the next one.